Hey guys, Cam here. Today we're going to do a color printing test on the Canon TS8220. Canon has this new series of PGI 280 CLI-281 cartridges that has those Pixma printers using it. TS8220 is before the TS8320. And right now you can see that both printers are the same. So I'm assuming if I reveal this one, it will be the same as TS8320. In the last video, I'm going to put a link above that we compared the Canon TS6320, which uses the same cartridge, except a blue cartridge. It doesn't have the blue cartridge. We plotted on a lab space. If you're not familiar, lab space vertically, this is the lightness is from really, really white to really, really dark. And the A axis is from green to red, and the B axis is from blue to yellow. And this is the old colors that this Canon printer can produce. And when we compare to a real photo printer, and the wireframe is the real photo printer. You can in the last video, we can show with regular cartridges, without blue cartridges, you can see the wireframe. This is much, much wider gamut than the Canon. So the Canon is not by itself, it's not the ideal color printer. So let's see if we can improve that with blue cartridge. This is the magic cartridge going to save the day. Let's see what a narrow gamut doing in real life. So on the left is the TS6330 that doesn't have the blue cartridge. And on the right, we have a real photo printer. You can see the left one look like a TV anchor, look like she's on, have some makeup, and her skin is kind of like fake. On the right, it's more real, it's more three-dimensional. Just pay attention to her cheekbone. You can see how three-dimensional it is, versus this one is like a totally plastic surgery. In the real photo printer, those patches, they're really evenly distributed. You don't see a big block of patches anywhere. And we already know the blue will be bad. And you can see the patch and a couple colors just lumped together. And the lightness is not enough either. The gray is you have to mixing up the old colors. Do you see red here? Pay attention to region 102 to 216. You can see the Canon is from white just to gray to dark, and the real printer, you have more transitions. Okay, let's see if we add a blue cartridge, and that will fix the problem. Overall, she looks a little bit more real now. Let's see if the blue cartridge fixed that ugly patch right here. You can see the patch is a lot more even. So that's a big improvement. And notice the improvement from the red to yellow, and especially the yellow is a lot more even than before. That's unexpected. And when you compare to the real photo printer, and the six cartridge, that blue cartridge really did some trick. It looked almost like a real photo printer now. I'm happy. Talks cheap. Let's make a real SEC and put it on the lab. This is our old five cartridge system. And let's put the six cartridge system that we test today. You can see just like what we've seen in the picture, the red and the yellow, that region improved a lot. That's really surprising what one small cartridge can do. And it beef up a lot on the blue side. So this is the improvement you got from investing one more cartridge. Now let's put on the real photo printer. And now the real printer is a wireframe again. So you can see, even with one extra blue cartridge, the Canon still has problem with the blue. And let's do a cross section so you can see. So in the cross section, you can see the outside layer is the real photo printer. And this is this one is the blue cartridge added, and the inside is the old 5 cartridge system. So the current Canon is halfway between the two, between the best and the worst. You can see that the separation going to be pretty consistent across all the lightness. And when the lightness change, your 6 cartridge, 5 cartridge, they are converge at some point. So they doesn't make a difference if you add an actual cartridge or not. However, for the real photo printer, it's always better than this. So my conclusion is, I'm going to suggest this 6 cartridge system to amateur or just somebody just started with a limited budget. And yes, you can use this printer and print some photos, even maybe do a little bit of commercial and selling those photos. But in the long run, you have to have a real photo printer. Hope you enjoyed this video. Cheers.